Royal baby live, Meghan Markle's baby imminent as drones band over Frogmore. Meghan Markle is due to give birth to baby Sussex today, it has been claimed. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are on standby but are believed to be relaxed about the arrival of the royal baby, and Prince Harry will even be attending today's London Marathon to hand out medals and support runners. Meghan will stay at home with her mum, Doria Ragland, who has been by her side at Frogmore Cottage, Windsor, for over a week. A royal source said, "It won't be long now. Meghan's really excited. Of course she's nervous like any first-time mum, but she and Harry can't wait. She's been preparing for the birth, she wants it to be as natural as possible, and so has been practicing hypnobirthing and breathing techniques with Harry. It's been a huge support having her mum by her side, and now she's just getting as much rest as she can." 3:08 PM update, baby Sussex won't use their first name. Neither Meghan nor Harry actually use their true first names in day-to-day life. Meghan was born Rachel Meghan Markle, although her family have called her Meghan since she can remember. The Duchess once joked this made her life hard, especially when it came to legal documents. A reporter once mistakenly called her Rachel after her character in Suits during a red carpet appearance in 2013. The reporter apologized for getting confused, and Meghan laughed and said, "Do you know my first name in real life is Rachel? I've never been called it, but my parents named me Rachel Meghan Markle, and it's just confused every legal document for my entire life. So you've just called me by my given name." Prince Harry's full name is Prince Henry Charles Albert David, but Prince Charles and Princess Diana called him Harry from birth. With both parents known as names other than their first, baby Sussex could also be given a nickname or decide to be called by his or her middle name. 2:39 PM update, what will the royal baby be called? The gender of Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's first child is unknown, but punters are backing a girl and favoring the name Grace according to bookmakers Ladbrokes. The names Grace and Diana are tied at 6-1, followed closely by Elizabeth at 8-1. For a boy's name, Arthur is at 8-1, Philip at 10-1 and James at 12-1. Royal baby name odds according to Ladbrokes. Grace 6-1. Diana 6-1. Elizabeth 8-1. Arthur 8-1. Philip 10-1. James 12-1. Alice 12-1. Victoria 16-1. Albert 16-1. 1:48 PM update, baby Sussex will dress like Prince George. Prince George was never publicly seen wearing trousers during his early years. Instead, the future king was pictured wearing shorts. The reason for this appears to be down to tradition. According to Harper's Bazaar, the upper class, aristocracy and royals tend to dress young boys in shorts. Etiquette expert William Hansen told the publication, "It's a very English thing to dress a young boy in shorts. Trousers are for older boys and men, whereas shorts on young boys is one of those silent class markers that we have in England. Although times are slowly changing, a pair of trousers on a young boy is considered quite middle class, quite suburban. And no self-respecting aristo or royal would want to be considered suburban. Even the Duchess of Cambridge." However, in a family photograph of the Cambridges released last December, Prince George was pictured wearing trousers. Prince George also wore trousers to Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's royal wedding in May 2018. 1:06 PM update, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry sent Idris Elba and Sabrina Dower £7,000 painting as a wedding present. Idris Elba, 46, and Sabrina Dower, 29, tied the knot in a ceremony in Marrakesh, with celebrations spread over 3 days. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex were unable to attend the wedding, despite Idris and Sabrina being present at theirs last May. But the pair didn't go without, as it's been reported Meghan Markle and Prince Harry sent the newlyweds a piece of art by the Connor brothers, worth £7,000. The artwork is believed to be a picture of a woman wearing a yellow dress with the words featured on the piece, "Why fit in when you were born to stand out?" 12:25 PM update, Prince Harry not worried as he appears at London Marathon. Prince Harry has arrived at the London Marathon, and looked incredibly relaxed despite the imminent birth of his child. The Duke arrived at the finishing line at around 11:45 p.m. to meet organizers. He is expected to give medals to the runner shortly. The royal family did not announce the visit in case there was news on his and Meghan's baby. 11:56 a.m. update. Prince William has revealed a phone call from his brother is imminent, but baby Sussex has not yet arrived. The Duke of Cambridge is currently in New Zealand to pay tribute to the victims of the terror attack in Christchurch. While meeting with well-wishers, Prince William was asked whether there was any sign of the royal baby. The Duke of Cambridge admitted he had no idea and joked the public would know before he did. He said, "I haven't got my phone on me, I have no idea. You guys will find out before I do at this rate." 11:35 a.m. update. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are already planning their first overseas trip with their child. Last week, it was revealed Meghan Markle and Prince Harry were making plans to move to Africa to live and work. And the Duke and Duchess could be taking their young one with them in the autumn. A royal source said, they hope to take the baby with them but will make a decision nearer the time. Potentially, Meghan and the baby could do some, if not all, of the trip. Baby Sussex is expected to become one of the youngest royals to ever go on an official tour. 11:02 a.m. update, Frogmore Cottage bans drones flying overhead. Police are said to be cracking down on use of drones above and around Meghan and Harry's home. Signs have been put around the area warning, police fight safety notice, drones prohibited in this area. The alerts have heightened speculation the royal baby is imminent. 10:24 a.m. update, Prince Philip played squash whilst Prince Charles was being born. Whilst Queen Elizabeth II was in labor with Prince Charles, Prince Philip decided to play squash. He also went for a swim and was reportedly told by a footman to hurry whilst drying after his dip, as his son had been born. Daily Mail journalist Steve Bird said, when the princess came around from her anesthetic, the Duke of Edinburgh was there with a bottle of champagne and a large bouquet of red roses and carnations, the Queen's favorite flowers, that his equerry had the foresight to buy earlier. In modern times, traditions surrounding births have changed drastically, with the father much more involved in the delivery room. 9:54 a.m. update, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry to up sticks and move to California. Thomas Markle Jr. says his pregnant sister will splash millions on a beachside home in Los Angeles. Thomas revealed that Meghan has a desire to set down roots in her home city of LA again, even though just 2 years ago she moved to London. Prince Harry is thought to be a big fan of the U.S., having served army time at a helicopter training base in California. In recent days, royal sources have claimed that the couple are expected to go on a deployment for the monarchy, with Africa being their most likely destination. But glass worker Thomas, 52, expects the couple to consider the U.S. West Coast either now or in the near future. He said, "I can see them having a house here somewhere. I can see anybody wanting to come and spend summers here on the beach, so it is possible. It is really easy to fall in love with the California lifestyle. The water is amazing here and you have this as your backyard. Who would not like this? Once you grow up as a child on the beach, you are always going to go back to it." Meghan was brought up in this environment, moved and is groomed into Hollywood life. The Hollywood lifestyle is the Southern California lifestyle, the sun, beach, bright lights, the city, studios and the movie business. She will always be a Hollywood Southern California woman at heart. 9:32 a.m. update, Meghan will remain at home as long as possible. It is believed Meghan wants to stay at home for as long as possible whilst in labor but understands hospital is the safest environment to give birth. Frimley Park Hospital in Surrey, which is only 30 minutes from their Windsor home, is on standby. A royal source told The Sun, which has claimed Meghan's due date is today, the plan has never changed and Meghan has been very clear what she wants. They added, "She is taking medical advice daily and she and Harry are very flexible and will be guided by their team. When she goes into labor, She wants to remain at home for as long as possible, but she's in a situation where if something did go wrong and she had to be whisked to hospital, she would be. There have been some ridiculous things said about her birth plan. Yes, she would like a female-led delivery, but the suggestion that the Queen's doctors have been banned is just not true. Alan Farthing and Guy Thorpe Beeston are involved in the planning and in the team as a whole, and it just depends how it all goes on whether they're needed. It just depends how it all goes on whether